This video is supported by viewers like you. If you want to help me make more things like this, consider supporting me on Patreon. Thank you. When you get on the metro in Vienna's Transdanubian wasteland and ride to the city center, you cross four bodies of water. Old Danube, New Danube, Danube, and Danube Canal. One Vienna, four Danubes. On first glance, that's confusing not only to newcomers. So what's up with that? Let's start at the beginning, in a simpler time, when the number of Danubes in Vienna was exactly one. The Danube has, in the few million years it's been around, as accumulation of numerous constantly changing branches, always made new ways for itself. Many branches dried up, others formed where none were before. Much of what later should become districts 2, 20, 21 and 22 was regularly flooded. The Danube's constant migration didn't bother people in the few first centuries of the city, since the old town, today's first district, lies on a flood-proof elevation, where neither god nor emperor could command it to go. Come on then, up you go! But at some point, the measly 2 square kilometers within the city walls were not enough, so more and more people moved to the villages and towns around Vienna, some of them near the Danube. And near the Danube, back then, terrible location to build. You go to work in the city, come back in the evening, and notice your shack's not there, and with that current already in Slovakia. On top of that, many a bridge kept getting torn away by water and ice, so something had to be done. Gingerly, humans started to interfere in the natural flow of the Danube. Straighten a branch here, drain another one there, and so on. Problem being, all these little measures weren't worth much if rain got heavy and the torrents washed everything away. Only solution? A complete river regulation. For that, they dug a near-straight 280-meter-wide riverbed from the city limits in the north all the way to the southeast. All other branches of the Danube were filled up, with two exceptions. A former main stream gone tributary, turning towards the old town and only joining the Danube much further downstream, was conserved and artificially kept in place, hence Danube Canal. And the then main stream now spends its days as a cut-off branch, therefore Old Danube. Most important for the whole venture, as we recall, was flood protection, for which on the left side, riverbanks are always seen with the current, a 450 meter wide strip of land was kept as floodplain. Nice try, not good enough. Despite the massive intervention, serious floods kept befalling the city these next 100 years. What to do? Regulate again. And a little quicker this time, if I may be so presumptuous. Most certainly, good sir. Take it easy, Buster. We're in no hurry. Second time round, they dug off about half of the floodplain and put it on top of the other half. Add some greens, a bunch of mosquitoes, and a few nudists, and there you've got the, not creatively, but very fittingly named, Danube Island. Island must stay island. Island must stay clean. Island must stay livable. And island must be worth it to drive here. And nice to see people and be able to say, wow. Why did they remove half the floodplain? That's to make room for a relief channel that usually, like the old Danube, is standing waters, but when there's danger of flooding, can be connected to the Danube via a weir system, which increases flow maximum significantly. But since relief channel doesn't sound that great at all, the city named it New Danube. And now our set is complete. So, in summary, listen up, that's on the test. There are 4 bodies of water in Vienna with the name Danube. The actual Danube, making the land on the stream what it is, the Danube Canal, a scaled-down former mainstream right next to the city center, the Old Danube, also a former mainstream that's not connected to the Danube anymore, and the New Danube, which usually doesn't flow anywhere either, but with a flood on the horizon, keeps our slippers dry.